generally, I think anybody, it's usually the more transparent the company, generally probably the more trustworthy they are if they're open about communication. But if you're like dodgy about things or have a track record of maybe bad behavior, then naturally that trust is going to be, you know, on thin ice, if at all. The fear is ultimately the bigger the biggest companies get, what alternatives do people really have, I guess, and how much do you, I mean, how much do you really have a choice, right? I guess at the end of the day, if there's no government regulation on things, and I'm not saying that's 100% the answer, but, you know, if there's no one to check you on it, then there's no reason to really stop, right? Kind of just keep stretching until the rubber band snaps, basically. And at that point, you've gone pretty far.
I think we're coming to the point, though, that the people that are going to start checking companies are the customers. I think we started out the premise of why are we doing this now? It feels like now the customers, consumers are starting to get a better understanding of what's going on. And it doesn't appear like they like it. And going back to Raju, you know, and I think the theme of trust, you know, trust is a currency too, you know, and if you have trust, then you have more opportunities to do things, but you have to be open to really being very transparent and saying exact and plain as plain a language as you can possibly say it. Here's what we want to use this data for. We want to use it to create a better experience and be honest, you know, create a better experience for you, but also, yeah, we will benefit too. And I don't think anybody has a problem with making a win-win situation where, yeah, I give you a little data, you give me something that I really value and appreciate, whether it's your platform or something else. And I think, you know, you get to a point where you don't have to worry about, you know, the stuff that happened in the past, because if you got trust, and you're willing to put it on the line, you know, because, you know, trust today could be gone tomorrow if you don't act right. So you have to have a culture and an environment that that says, we're going to tell you what we want to do. We're going to be very open about it. Yeah, if you have questions, we'll be glad to answer that. And in return for that, we're going to do this and you're going to get that.
People don't pay too much attention to trust, Ben, because you cannot measure that. We are into that measuring and number-centric mindset that, you know, if it's something cannot be measured, then they tend to ignore it. Well, they tend to think it's not important. And to some extent, we have come to this position with the surveillance due to, I say, marketers' addiction towards numbers. To me, that is the root cause. It is marketers that are addicted towards numbers that are, you know, want to hyper-target, want to know the ROI of their campaigns and whatnot, are putting demand and pressure on these surveillance companies or these ad companies who end up, you know, so providing the data to marketers. So to even provide the data, they have to do the surveillance that results in tracking and whatnot. So to me, it goes back to this thing where, you know, people's or marketers' addiction towards numbers is one of the root cause of where we are today, which has resulted in privacy and privacy abuse.